Welcome to our video on how to use the pump selector. In this video, we are going to cover the hydraulic selection, including a specified duty point, as well as piping and different kinds of fluids that may be selected. So this is the most extensive video that we will offer on the pump selection. So if you go to our website, www.tsurumi.eu, on the left-hand side in the menu bar at the very bottom, you see the pump selector. If you log on to the pump selector and you select in the middle of the field the hydraulic selection, you get to the main screen of the selection. So as always, it's important to know the application where the customer wants to use the pump. So on the top left hand, you can pre-select the application slash the portfolio within you are looking for a matching pump. So you've got contractor pumps here, pumps with agitators and sewage pumps. For our example, we're going to take the contractor pumps. On the bottom left, you see then the whole contractor pump portfolio where you can also deselect certain items if you don't want them included, for example, KRS with agitator. First of all, we're going to enter the specified duty point as illustrated in our previous video. Here you have the opportunity to show more options. This is something that we do not recommend. If you choose less options, it's a lot easier to understand. And here under flow and head, you can enter your specified duty point. So for our example, we will choose a duty point of 250 cubic meters per hour. Here on the right-hand side, you can choose the measurements and change them to liters per second, liters per minute, etc. And we say it's 50 meter head. Now, as a default, because you've selected contractor pumps, the fluid has been set to drainage water. And you see, if you try to select a different fluid, it only offers you water. Now, if you want to be really specific, because the customer has told you it's not just drainage water, it's drainage water with 10 or 20% dry matter content, you can also consider these values in your selection. For that purpose, please tick the box up here, show all fluids. Now you have the option to select many different kinds of fluids. And for this specific example, we've got different options for drainage water. You see 1.1, 1.2, and so forth. So drainage water 1.1 is water with 10% dry matter, drainage water 1.2 with 20%, 30% and 40%. Please note that our pumps for this pump selection software will support until 1.2, so 20% of dry matter content. For this example though, we choose 1.1. And as you see now, in comparison to drainage water before, the density has changed to 1,100. And this will be considered now in the calculation. However, the customer has phoned you and he's not just said that the specific duty point is 250 cubic meters per hour and with a 50 meter head. He also told you that he's got pipes already installed, which he wants you to consider in your calculation as well. For that purpose, you enter into the friction loss calculation, which can be found on top of the screen here. If you select the friction loss calculation, a new window will open up. For this purpose, because we are only addressing a relatively simple calculation for a pump with piping and some elbows, please do not change or choose any other installation as suggested up here. You are right now in the standard, which works the best. So this is just one pipe and one pump. So before we start adding pipes, etc., first of all, easy to forget, you must re-enter the geodetic head here in the drawing. So here we enter 50 meters. Now, the bottom of the screen is a bit confusing. Therefore, we suggest that you first of all select or tick the box, hide elements with quantity zero. Now you have got a much better overview. Now, depending on how your customer has provided information, whether piping is already installed or whether he wants to install pipes, there are two options. So as you are probably aware, different diameters of pipes will have an influence on the velocity. Therefore, if you select here, for example, a DN200 piping, you can see already that the flow velocity will be 2.2 meters per second. If you change this to DN100, for example, or you can change it to DN250, you see it's 1.4. On the subject of velocity, a few remarks from our side. So if you are dealing with sewage or wastewater treatment applications, in general, we recommend a minimum velocity of 0.7 meters per second to 1 meter per second as a minimum. For construction site applications, so for drainage applications, we recommend a minimum velocity of 1.5 meters per second up to 4 meters per second. On the subject of velocity, please note that the higher the velocity is, the more wear will occur on the pump. So if you have got a velocity of 4 meters per second inside of the pipe, the wear on the pump will be a lot higher. So in our case, we are now selecting the DN250 piping, and then you select standard and you add this. So on the very right-hand side, you can enter the length of the piping, which for our example, we say it's 100 meter. Now you see, however, that the velocity is very low. This would mean that if you want to transport dry matter like sand or gravel, you might not have enough velocity to transport the dry matter. So this is not good piping. So if a customer has suggested this diameter of piping to you, you can already give them feedback that that sort of diameter is not a very good choice. If you're lucky enough that you can specify the piping, even the better, because this program can help you in finding the right diameter. So as you can see, DN250, we've got 1.4 meters per second, which will hardly be enough to transport the dry matter, but could potentially work. So in this case, I will delete this option by pushing the basket on the very right-hand side. Now, we would like to guide the customer to a better solution, which would be DN200, for example. Here we say we've got 2.2 meters per second, which, remember, we set a minimum velocity of 1.5 meters per second up to a maximum of 4 meters per second. This is right in the middle. So this is actually a good choice for 10% dry matter. So we select this by adding, and we say it's 100 meters pipe length. And you see inside of the pipe, you've got 1.77 meters. So that is actually good. That's the geodetic head loss that you actually incur. So by the friction loss caused inside of the pipe, you actually create virtually more geodetic head. This 1.77 will later on be added to the geodetic head. You can also add elbows, for example. So if you select elbows here and you say you've got, let's say, a 90 degree bend, and you add this by clicking the add button here, and you say the cusp. So you see here on the right hand side, one elbow would increase the geodetic head by 0.11 meters. So it's not necessarily a lot, but if you want to be super accurate, you can add these elbows. So we say 3, and you've added 0.3 meters geodetic head, which is reflected up here on the screen. Now, in order to illustrate to your customer that you've done the friction loss calculation correctly, you can also print out a data sheet on the friction loss by clicking down here. And you have got then a PDF document, which you can also send to the customer to illustrate that you've actually had a look at the friction loss in detail as well. You can also add all sorts of valves. If you check up here, isolating valves, you've got also other fittings. So you can select your elbows, filters, non-return valves, etc., transition pieces. You can go into all sorts of details depending, as illustrated already down here, one elbow in terms of friction loss does not create massive friction loss. However, if your customer says he has installed in the 100 meter pipe more than 20 elbows, it's probably something worth considering. If it is just one or two elbows, it might also be okay to not add these. Nevertheless, the more accurate you can be, the better. So now we've added all the accessories, and we've finished now the friction loss calculation. This is the point where you click at the bottom, OK. So now you see we're back on the top screen where we had beforehand entered our duty point. But now you see that to the geodetic head of 50 meters, 2.11 meters have been added because of friction loss. If you click on next at the bottom of the screen, the software will now look for pumps that could potentially match the specified duty point. And we find that we have got only two matches. Please note on this screen, at the moment you see the dotted lines. The problem is that I've got the setting wrong. The drive is not under-designed. This is a problem in the setting. So you can simply reduce the dotted line by clicking draw motor power rating limitation. And now you've got the correct line. This is the correct pump performance curve, and this is valid. So you see, we've got two options. We've got the LH875, which in terms of specified duty point is a little bit far away in terms of the operating duty point. However, the operating duty point is very close to the best efficiency point, which is positive. We also have the LH855, which in terms of operating duty point on the curve is also very close to the best efficiency point. However, we need to have a closer look now at the operating duty point and how far it is away from what the customer actually wanted. So the customer said, according to the friction loss calculation, we needed 52 point something in terms of geodetic head. This is 51.82. So it's slightly below the specified duty point in terms of geodetic head. So, and if you have a look at the cubic meters per hour, we said 250 cubic meters per hour. This is only 230 cubic meters per hour. The other option is an LH875. So it's a 20 kilowatt bigger motor. Here we are actually overperforming on the duty point. So the geodetic head was 52 point something. Here we've got 53.3. And the flow is actually at 312 cubic meters per hour. So the flow is tremendously bigger than what the customer required. So we've got two options now, and this is where we need to talk to the customer again. We have the option that we outperform the required duty point in terms of flow, but we can match the geodetic head, or we go below the specified duty point. As mentioned in our previous videos, you also have the option to send these data sheets, including the operational duty point, to your customer. Simply click on the left-hand side onto data sheets, and there you have the data sheet with the specified duty point. You can send this by simply clicking the download button up here, and then you can select LH875, and you can download this sheet there. And you can send both options to the customer. But according to the specified duty point and the piping specified, this is what you can offer to the customer inside of the Tsurumi portfolio. So this is it for the hydraulic selection so far. There's plenty of other features around the hydraulic selection, and we will cover other features soon in different videos. So in case you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at sales@tsurumi.eu, and please stay tuned for more videos. Thank you very much.